Hello, this is a virtual pathology specimen from a case of Hirschsprung disease, and this is therefore a rectum and the sigmoid colon from a young baby. And here we have a very small diameter, shrunken looking segment of rectum, and proximal to this is a very dilated sigmoid colon. We can see that the sigmoid colon has actually been cut open. The wall is slightly thin and it's very dilated and appears quite translucent. We are looking at the mucosal surface and we do not see any obvious ulcers in this case. And if we look at the very atrophic segment of rectum, we can see that the diameter is extremely small. Turning this around, we can see how thin the wall is. There is no evidence of perforation. So let's learn a little bit about Hirschsprung disease. Hirschsprung disease is also known as congenital aganglionic megacolon. The name actually kind of gives you a clue as to the actual pathology, and this is a congenital absence of ganglion cells in the submucosal as well as the myenteric plexuses of the distal rectum. And this also can affect a variable length of colon proximal to this. So the affected area is usually very atrophic and shrunken looking with a very small diameter, and this gives rise to a functional obstruction and therefore dilatation of the proximal colon. So in this picture, we actually can see that this is the area that is the aganglionic segment, and this is actually the normally innervated dilated proximal colon. It occurs in about 1 in 5,000 live births, and clinically, usually the first sign is the failure to pass meconium in the newborn baby. There may also be other signs of bowel obstruction, such as swollen abdomen, peristalsis that you can actually see, and also bilious vomiting. Of course, some serious complications can occur, including enterocolitis, perforation even, and fluid and electrolyte imbalances. Treatment is to resect the aganglionic segment and to anastomose the proximal normal colon to the distal rectum. There will be a separate talking slide on the microscopic features of Hirschsprung disease, but just in a nutshell, the affected segment will have no ganglion cells, and this will happen both in the submucosal plexus as well as the myenteric plexus in the deeper smooth muscle wall or the muscularis propria. So here we have colonic mucosa, submucosa, and there are some prominent nerve bundles in this submucosal region. However, there are no ganglion cells, and this is what we would see in the aganglionic shrunken segment. Conversely, in the normal innervated proximal dilated segment, we would see the presence of ganglion cells within the nerve plexuses. So in the proximal bowel, sometimes there may be ulcers, longitudinal ulcers due to fecal impaction. There may also be perforation and sometimes smooth muscle hypertrophy. Hence, in summary, this is a gross pathology specimen of a case of Hirschsprung disease. This is a segment of very shrunken, small diameter atrophic looking rectum, which is the aganglionic segment, and the proximal dilated sigmoid colon. This is the normally innervated segment. And Hirschsprung disease is a congenital disease that gives rise to functional bowel obstruction. It is treated with surgical resection of the affected aganglionic segment. This virtual pathology specimen, along with some other useful clinical vignettes or descriptions, and sometimes also videos of talking pots and slides. These are taken from our online pathology resource, Pathweb, and you can register for free, and the registration link is in the video description. Thank you.